Hello everybody and welcome to another tutorial. Today I'm going to be explaining how to make sub bass stand out on small speakers. Now if you're a producer, I'm sure you've had this problem. Everyone has. When you're super chuffed with a mix, you put it on your phone to take a listen to try and check it out in a different surrounding, and that sounds absolutely terrible. You're like, where is my sub bass gone? Where is that rhythm gone from the track and that groove? And how can I get around it? Well, the way you get around that is by adding upper harmonics, which give the illusion of a bass sound. Because when you listen to a track on a small speaker, you can't actually hear the subs. What you can hear is the upper harmonics creating the illusion of a bass. Okay, so I'll show you what I mean by that. So we have a sub bass sound. Okay, very standard sound. And what we are going to do is we are going to add upper harmonics. So at the moment, if we look at span, if you don't know what I mean by harmonics, we can see here we are going from around 40 to around 150, and then it's tailing off down here. Right? So around 40 to 150, then it starts to tail off. And the problem is we are losing all of this upper register, and this is the area where the small speakers will pick up the frequencies, okay? But anywhere down here, they're not able to pick it up. The speakers just don't have that range. So we have to try and trick the mind in thinking we can hear the bass when it's up here. All right, so the way we do that is by distortion and saturation mainly. So first of all, we are going to add a send track. Because we don't want to distort the original, we want to add a little bite to the original, okay? Because we're not, otherwise we'd just have a big grungy sub, okay? And then it wouldn't be the same. So what we do is we add a send track. Simply on FL Studio, all you have to do is go to Fruity Send and pop one of them in, okay? But you can do this in any DAW. And then you simply right click and sidechain to this track. Okay, then you go into Fruity Send and you change it to 2. So then it shows up in both categories. Okay, just like this. So as you can see there, now we've got a duplicated copy playing next to it. Now, this is not going to improve the harmonics. It's just going to be exactly the same because there's 2 playing. It's just a bit louder. So that's not what we want to achieve. What we need to achieve is distortion and saturation to try and stretch and create that harmonic range, okay? So first of all, we are going to use a camel crusher. You don't have to use this. It's just for the purpose of the tutorial. Using a camel crusher, and we'll just watch the difference that makes already. So as you can see here, there's a big change, right? All of these upper harmonics have now appeared, and that is what's going to stand out on the small speakers. We can also add some saturation. And we'll watch this one here. You can hear the way it's changing. Now that adds a real meat to the bass. It adds a real power and presence. And that's what we want to achieve. But now you're probably thinking, I don't like the sound of that bass anymore. You've ruined the original sub, which I wanted to keep. And that's the beauty of doing it this way, because you keep the original sound and you just add that little bite to make it stand out on the phones and on the speakers. So what we do is we start with the original, and then we gradually increase the send until it's just enough that it's not changing our sound, but it's adding them upper harmonics that we are missing. See, even that slight bit there is already making a difference. You can see all of this extra here that we didn't have before. All right, so we could even slightly increase. And now we've created far more harmonics to the bass without changing its sound. You won't notice that extra little bite in the mix. Okay, this is solely when it's on its own. You can just about hear it. When it's amongst the mix, you're not going to notice. And when you play it back on your phone speakers, you are going to hear the sub that was missing before. So that is how you're going to overcome this problem, okay? Plus, there's other EQing tricks that you can do as well. But the main thing is to gain them upper harmonics, which the speakers can actually pick up. Because if your sub is too low, then the speakers won't stand a chance and you're literally just going to hear nothing back. All right, guys? So I hope you've learned something today and I hope that makes sense. If you've got any questions, please leave them below for about this video or for any other videos you'd like me to make. I hope it all makes sense. So there we go, guys. I'll see you soon.